we descend as if to the depths of Polish history and faith.
Mark, this is stunning. This is unlike anything I've ever seen before. Where are we right now?
We are in the most famous and the deepest underground church of the world. It's called the Chapel of Saint Kinga. Everything you may see around here was carved by three miners, amateurs.
Only three miners?
Yes. It took them 67 years.
Everything I see here is salt.
Reliefs, figures, altars, chandeliers made of salt crystals.
The floor also,
which is one single block of salt, 101 meter below the surface.
Salt as art? Well, the skepticism melts as you wind your way through this wonder of a mine shaft. It is a thing of beauty carved from the most basic of elements, rock salt. For centuries, this was also a working salt mine, a real treasure for a Polish kingdom when salt was as valuable as oil.
This is a working mine. It produced salt for many, many years, centuries really. Why the artwork? Why the sculptures? Why? How did all this come to be?
First, miners, they carved figures in chapels, in churches, underground. They wanted to have places to pray. Their work was dangerous. There were floods, there were fires, there were explosions of methane. So they wanted to pray. So first, really, they carved figures in churches. We still have underground about 40 chapels.
40,
exactly.
Lots of places to pray for your health.
This is a vast warren of artful beauty, totally unexpected. It's easy to forget when you're down here that this is salt, the kind that's usually next to the pepper. And here is still another part of this mine, a place where we have an exclusive look-see. But not before we don on some safety gear. Top engineers here tell us, of course, they are working to keep the mine from caving in. But what really keeps them up at night?
The most dangerous thing, and the challenge, which is still very important and dangerous, is the water, fresh water.
Thousands of liters of water per day still seep into this mine. During communist days, many here worried about preservation and, more crucially, if the Soviets could really appreciate what this place means to Polish history.
Why do you think it's such an important place historically?
Because it shows, I think, all parts of Polish history. They are almost shown here in the mine.
Salt was as important to the Polish kingdom back then as oil or gold would be today. It sustained livelihoods, culture, and faith. What's surprising is that it's all now perfectly reflected in the art and architecture of a place lovingly built, not by commissioned artists, but patriotic miners. Paula Newton, CNN, Wieliczka, Poland.